Right now, just want to make sure I'm still recording. That would suck.
That would be great.
All right, so to continue this series, I'm going to be sitting here with Joe. Joe is going to be leaving us very shortly, unfortunately. Joe's been here for how long?
2 years and 3 months.
2 years and 3 months? 2 3 months, huh? 2 years, 2 months, whatever, it doesn't matter. 2 years is...
Good enough.
Longer than most for us, I will say. Unfortunately for me, I'm married here, so...
You're a lifer.
I am a lifer. Joe, you're from the United States?
Yes, I'm
obviously.
From Boston.
Okay.
East Coast.
East Coast, yes. I'm from the East Coast of Canada myself, so you all know about that. So, Joe, just a few questions I have for you because, you know, you'll be leaving soon. And just to go through, you know, kind of the experience you had in the 2+ years that you've been here. So, let's start off with pros and cons. Let's go with, like, 3 pros you like about this city.
Okay, 3 pros. Living in Suzhou, your lifestyle is definitely more luxurious than it would be at home.
Oh.
I have a cleaning lady. I get my feet scrubbed, pedicures, manicures, whenever you want.
Mm.
You go out to eat for most meals. We're eating out now.
Yeah.
And usually, I don't care what the bill is. I don't even look at the price of the bill. I'm just going to pay it, and then I'm going to go.
Something you want, you get it.
Whereas at home, how much is that? Well, maybe I'll get this instead.
I'm not that hungry. I guess it's ramen tonight.
Ramen works. Domino's from yesterday is okay.
Yeah, cool pizza.
But like here, lifestyle definitely is fancier than it would be at home.
Much.
But at least easier to live that lifestyle. Another pro, the people that you meet.
Yeah.
From not just Chinese people, but like the foreigners that conglomerate here.
Yeah.
And like all different walks of life.
Yeah, we do have a lot.
Wide selection, and you think a lot about a country. Well, you don't think a lot about a country, but then when you're faced with this person from this country, you have to talk about, like, you start learning things about this country, and you're like, I didn't think that. And the perspectives change, and like all these ideas that you have before kind of switch up on you when you like actually get to know someone or like groups of people from countries.
Totally agree.
So it's a pro. I mean, it could be a con too, but it's good to, I think it's a pro because it allows you to figure out like, okay, I shouldn't use whatever I think I know to go up and talk to people from that place. They'll tell me and then I'll decide from that, like how I feel. But like no prejudgment kind of like puts you in your place a little bit. Like you think you know a lot of things and then you're like, oh no, it's different. The world is bigger out there.
That is very true.
A third pro I'd say are the Chinese people that you meet, and actually living in China. And I think it's so funny that like at home, there's all these things that you say like if someone, where'd you go to get that China? And you're like, wait, I'm in China. You have a perception of Chinese people too.
Yeah, there's
and it's literally nothing. Nothing that I thought it was.
A lot of people said in that.
Thought all the houses would have like those little corners.
The old
ancient style architect all the temples have.
The funny hats.
The cones everywhere.
Kung fu all day long.
The way of lifestyle is not, I guess I didn't think about their way of lifestyle.
Mm.
Like their daily life to life interactions, but then it's like very different from what I'm accustomed to.
Culture.
And I've also realized it's different from like the Western world kind of has more of a idea of the Western world's doing. Because like I said, with meeting people from different countries, we do a lot of things like, or like things are more similar, dresses more similar, like ideas and things like this. And then you meet Chinese people and it's like completely different world. And I said that's a pro too, because I really grown to love a lot of things about Chinese culture, about Suzhou Ren specifically. Like, you know, there's people here that you meet, you're married.
Yeah.
I mean, that's
it's
just like an example.
Given for me.
Right. But it's cool, it's interesting.
Excellent. Now, cons.
Okay, I feel like the cons are easy. I've had these cons for like 2 years. The smell. Let's just talk about the scent. Why is there a constant scent down every road and street? I can't describe it. It's a specific to China. And then Suzhou even has its own little scent. But like China has a smell. There's a smell here. We've grown accustomed to it, but it's probably right here, right now, lingering around.
Yeah, there's almost like a sweet and sour smell.
Sometimes usually sour.
Grease
or oil, I don't know.
Well, it's because, you know, when they
cook and they throw cook it all outside.
Well, yeah, they have the people that come and, you know, they save it and then pick it up in buckets, and then, you know, some of that sometimes goes down the drain. Not often, but I've seen it go poured down the drain. That doesn't help. And then they have you ever seen it when they clean it out?
No.
Oh my god.
I tend to just avoid any scenes of spilling oil, carrying oil. Usually if someone's carrying it after something out of a restaurant that I'm going to go eat at, I'm like, not even going to look. I'm still going to eat it. not going to look. It makes it easier. All
right, the smell's a con.
The smell. Another con. It's not so much a con as a cultural difference, but one thing that's really hard to get over sometimes is the way of thinking. Let's say logic. Logic in China, or Shuzhou, I'll be more specific, it's different cities.
Different countries.
Logic here is not logic that I know to be logic. Common sense is not so common, like I find it.
I really worry about the people crossing the streets.
Oh, someone's gonna. Well, people die up here, but like.
It's very.
The way they drive, like, I don't understand. That's another logical point. Like, where are you going with traffic?
I've done a few driving videos.
I've almost got
sideswiped a few times.
Driving is interesting.
It is.
Driving is interesting.
So, yeah, different forms of logic, different cultures.
And I said it as a con. I know it's different cultures and stuff.
But we're not.
But some things are just not, like, just pure, like, logically thinking. Some,
yeah.
And again, that is culture, right? Like, yeah. We think it's logical. They think that is
it's
logical.
It's not logical. So
it's crazy, some of the, like, systems in place for, like. But
that's what
it's a different culture.
That's what they do.
It's a different culture.
That's what they.
So the smell, the logic, another con.
The third con.
I thought it was gonna be easy to say third con. What's another con?
If you can't think of one, it's alright. Don't worry about it. Two's fine.
Yeah, I'm not gonna make up one.
Yeah.
I feel like smell was a big one, and logic kind of covers a lot of things.
Yeah.
So like smell and logic is.
Smell and logic, it is just two cons. So that's more pros than cons. See, that's a good thing.
That's a good one.
That's a good one. All right, now, so we are in Shuzhou, and you know there is some local food in Shuzhou and local drink in Shuzhou. What do you think about the food in Shuzhou?
Well, when you say local food, I think Shaokao, and then I think
Shaokao is big.
I love Shaokao.
Shaokao's awesome.
Shaokao's great.
Unless it gets, well, I mean, for me, it's the spice kills me on the Shaokao.
Sometimes you can control that.
Yeah. I mean, if you ask ahead of time, you can kind of control it. It's just be wary, is what I am.
Everything is spicy. You know, I hated anything spicy before I came here. I wouldn't even, like, touch anything that looked like a pepper because it might be spicy.
I am at that point of my time.
Have you gotten there? Because I've actually transformed the other way.
If I even see the pepper or the slice of pepper, no matter if it's like the small one or the large green one that they have, I'm like, nah, that just
it's
automatic.
Gonna be spicy.
No.
Before I wouldn't touch it, now I'm like, whatever. Because I realized you can't dodge the spice here. The spice is everywhere. Become one with the spice or else you're going to be hungry.
I'm hungry a lot. I am very hungry a lot. Yeah, Shaokao is a big thing. I mean, very famous in Shuzhou and the barbecue. Very, very famous. Any others?
I think of traditional dishes like egg and tomato, but I find that to be like Chinese dishes.
Yeah, I mean, this regular Chinese.
But like egg and tomato is something I'd never even fathom putting together.
Yes.
But I eat so often.
And it is good. I mean, tomato puts a nice little sweet on that egg.
Yeah, and the way like that juice from the tomato comes out.
I thoroughly love
rice,
that. Yeah.
I don't like the noodles, but with rice and good.
Yeah, I love
hot pot.
Hot pot's good.
Love me some hot pot. I prefer the all beef one, yoba. Really good.
Yeah.
Hot pot, light hot pot. I'd say those are the big ones though.
That's good.
Egg and tomato, Shaokao, and hot pot. There you go. There's Chinese.
Excellent. Now, drink. Because.
Ganbei.
Yeah. Can't drink right now. I gotta drive a little bit more. So. But I will drink tonight, and I will make sure that everybody sees this as well.
That's important.
So what do you think about, like,
the drinking culture? Or their drinks? Because their drinks, that's two very different things.
Yeah, I mean, let's break it down, like, the Chinese alcohol.
Okay.
What do you think about Chinese? I mean, they have the Qingdao and
I prefer not
Harbin.
To drink it. I'm drinking currently a Raging Bitch, which is brewed in America, actually, in New York.
This one's brewed in New York?
Yeah. I didn't Raging know until right now. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's a fusion. I remember seeing that.
It's just 8.9. Look at that. 8.9 alcohol.
In, well, say in a small bottle as well, 8.9%. Yeah.
And I can have like 14 chindals. No.
Yeah.
But like, that, this is like three chindals. Like,
oh, even the small ones, yeah, or the cans? The cans are 4.3.
The bottles are like 3.3
at the one, max. Yeah, 3.1.
Sometimes
at the
there's beers that I find like that are two, like a snow or something. Those things are like 2. Why am I drinking? Just for calories? I don't drink for calories.
So you don't like the Chinese beer?
I would not be a fan. I do like baijiu.
You do?
I like baijiu.
Oh, man.
I like the baijiu bite. I like the culture of drinking too, but baijiu, when I get a baijiu dinner, it's like, yeah, I'm drinking baijiu. And baijiu, I mean, it's baijiu.
Yeah,
it's strong, bitter, like after.
It's definitely
it's got
up
a
there.
Kick. It's not 3%, I'll tell you that.
it starts at about 40. It's anywhere it's to like 80. 70 or 80.
I've had an 80 bottle.
Yeah.
Baijiu strong. I like it though.
I love it.
But their beers and their other liquor. Well, I don't. What's their liquor? And can I trust it? It's probably not.
Well,
maybe that's a con.
They have
that's gonna
red
be my
wine,
third con, you mentioned.
Like the unsureness
of
products.
Anything.
Anything in front of you? The unsureness?
Just unsureness. Is this a plate? I don't know. No. But like the unsureness of like. Oh, shishia. This is delicious though. Come to Black Dog. It's good.
Yes.
Like, are these Nikes? I don't know.
Well.
Is this brand? I have no idea.
Yeah,
is this really a New Balance? Is this a Jordan like t-shirt? Probably not.
I've bought a few fake shoes. I mean, it's just because
I have
like,
a fake pair of New Balances.
My size is just too big for China. I gotta get 50s and then the
girl, size 11.
That's.
I got shoes from
it's
home.
Hard, it's hard.
But the I don't like that. That whole like. It's fine if it's fake. You can tell usually by the price. It's fine if it's fake.
Yeah.
I don't care that it's fake. I don't like if I'm going to buy something real.
And then
I'm
going to
spend real money.
Yeah.
And then be like, but is it really that?
All
there's
right,
a lot
so
of that.
We'll add that onto the third con.
But going back to the drinks.
The drink.
The liquor.
Liquor.
You go to Muse, are you drinking Hennessy? No.
No.
I drink Fairshire Hennessy in my day. That's not Hennessy.
Yeah. Muse is, they wait till everybody gets drunk and then they probably pass off the odd alcohol.
So, drinking culture, I enjoy going to baijiu dinners and like gambe. I like that whole like unity with drinking. We're all gonna get drunk together.
Yeah.
It's like forced drunk.
And it's great
together.
To go to those
good.
Massive tables. You got
oh,
the food,
food
spinning around.
Spin the table, go ahead.
You know what I mean?
I love veggies.
And then the baijiu
and then
cheers and people. Yeah.
But the actual liquor, no.
Yeah. Well, that's good. Alright, how about language? I mean, how did you come over here? Did you know any Chinese?
I knew ni hao.
You knew ni hao? You're more than me when I came
I
over here.
I didn't know zaijian, but I knew ni hao.
As soon as I came over here, I was just like, oh my god, what did I do?
I didn't know any Chinese, and I don't know where I was going. I did not think about it, I'll tell you
no.
that. I was just like, I'm here. Then everyone was like, blah, 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 blah. I'm like, well, it sounds like you're speaking Chinese. And I was like, you are speaking Chinese. I don't know that language.
So, in 2 years, plus that you've been here, how do you think your Chinese is now?
Not very good.
Your listening is great.
My speaking is not as good. I never studied. I never went to classes. I don't know any characters. Super illiterate. Don't give me a character. I know I, you, and like love. And probably like how, the and like a few other ones. Simple
about,
ones.
Like numbers? How about numbers are pretty easy.
I don't know how to read the numbers. Only when I'm playing Mahjong do I ever see the numbers.
Sweet.
And then I'm like, I know
this
I
one.
Know this one's 5 and I know this one's 6, but
yeah.
But like generally speaking, I don't, like super illiterate. I know the exit symbol is the first symbol I learned, because when I came out the airport, I was like, get me out. How do I go? But I feel like I do all right for someone that never studied. I can get by, I can have conversations, I'll go to dinners with Chinese people.
Yeah.
I like, body language is 55% communication.
Yeah.
Tone is like 38, I think.
Yeah.
You know, you can get by with these things.
You definitely
plus
can.
That little bit of Chinese.
And the alcohol helps
and
out.
The baijiu. The gambe.
When you get down to the
alcohol. To be more gambe, and I actually speak a lot better than I do without
same
them.
With me. It's just like I become fluent.
Because the confidence is like, what?
Yeah, I'm very nervous to say the wrong thing.
And the tones are so like he has to be so careful of tone.
Yes.
Like and I'm like, come on, you know what I'm saying? That like, I have no idea. But yeah, it's like
taxicabs, no idea what you're saying sometimes. It's really difficult there. And that's what makes you worried though. It makes you nervous because like, I know I'm saying it right, but this guy's saying I don't understand.
Right.
And I'm like,
I know I sound like a Lawai foreigner when I say it, but I can't say it like so perfectly, so I'm scared to like try. But listening is good. Usually I'm like, oh, I know what people are saying, unless there's like too much happening.
Yeah.
Don't get me wrong, I'm not perfect.
Speed as well.
A little speed's okay. And then this is what kills me. The huas. Shuzhou hua. Or Shanghai hua. So every city you go to has a different like type
form
of
dialect.
Yeah, a different form of dialect for that city. It's basically like Mandarin, but like with a twist. I can't do that. You're really confusing me because and they all can pick it up like, oh, this person from Beijing. I'm like, this person, another...
It just looks like another person from China.
Chinese person,
doesn't sound like the Beijing Hua to the Shuzhou Hua.
I was like, no, I know that. Why don't I understand this? You're going to throw me... That's confusing. Because when people start speaking Shuzhou Hua, I'm always like, stop. Shuzhou has a lot of grunting. I need you to speak regular Chinese because I can't learn too much at once. But... the language is interesting though. I like speaking Chinese. I find like when I don't have to, I'm speaking Chinese.
Yeah.
But like talking to my friends from home, which are like, what are you saying? I'm like, shemiza. What is, or like little things like, zui, zui, zui. Like, okay, correct.
Yeah, you do catch yourself.
And then they're like, what? I'm like, oh, you need to learn a few words because I'm going to say these things now.
When you get back.
I told them already.
I'm going to blow your mind.
I speak Chinese. It was great. When I went home last time, just for a little bit, I would say like, simple sentence like, it's a plate. And everyone was like, wow!
They're blowing up. Oh my God,
she speaks Chinese! I'm like,
get her a degree!
Don't test me though, don't bring me in Chinese.
You're down.
Please don't.
You're down. You're like, nope.
They'll kill me, especially if I'm speaking the Huas. But Chinese is an interesting language.
Definitely. Oh, language, that's great. Now, how about you know, people? Local people.
I like Shuzhou people.
Yeah.
There's different characters of people. There's your Shaokao people.
Yeah.
Shaokao men are usually like men. They got big belly, shirts rolled up
right here.
Yeah,
they do.
Got tattoos. Usually not even here on their leg.
Yeah.
Tight little shirt. They're little short. Those are like the Shaokao men. They're usually like Baijiu every day. Shaokao people. Mm. They're at Shaokao every night.
They're good to hang out with.
They are. I've seen them at Shaokao. That's how I know them. Shuzhou people are cool. They're not so like, I've been to a lot of other cities, they don't think too highly of themselves.